Hello, my besties. How are you? In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to make this adorable bicycle wall planter for just $1. Also, at the end of this video, you can see how I changed up my window decor for the season. So the only thing that you have to buy to make the bicycle wall planter is this galvanized planter bucket from the Dollar Tree. If you watch my channel for a while, you probably have the rest of the supplies already. You know how I always tell you to save your stems when you make the wreaths or arrangements? Well, we're gonna need some of these stems. We're gonna need one bushel of small stems, like from the daisies, for example, and a couple long ones, like from the ferns or sunflowers or garden stakes, something long. And you're gonna need some paint. I'm gonna use the hammered metal paint because I used that in the past to make the windmill for my little truck. If you don't have this color, don't worry, use whatever you have. A teal bike would be cute, cream. So it doesn't have to even be a spray paint. You can use a 50-cent apple barrel paint from Walmart. In addition, I'll be using a couple of these foam darts from the Nerf gun. Maybe you could ask your son or grandson. Also, a piece of a tiara from Happy New Year, maybe birthday princess. Or maybe you can substitute these items with something else that you have around the house. Let me show you what I did. I took one of my longer stems, about 20 inches long, and I bent it so it looks like bicycle handlebars. And don't mind the brown tape peeling. I'm just going to remove it. My stem was wrapped in the brown paper tape. Here you can see exactly how I bent it. Next, I separate my stems and remove any leaves. So you separate all the stems in more or less equal distance from each other and lay them flat. And we're going to remove the big stem, we don't need it. So you probably figured that these will be the spokes for our wheel, and we're gonna bend another stem to make the rim. And it's gonna make half a wheel, just like that. And I'm using a chalk pen to mark exactly where to cut off the excess stems. But first, let me add glue dots so I could attach that rim. We have a large gap here, so I'm just gonna cut one more stem to add an additional spoke. And just checking with my ruler to make sure the spacing is more or less the same. Doesn't have to be exact. This is a vintage bag, so that's a great thing about it. Doesn't have to be perfect. And now I'm gonna trim the excess. All right, so we have a nice half a wheel, but I feel like we should reinforce it a little bit. You see over here where the spokes are sticking up, I want to put another stem on top of it, create one more rim on the other side. All right, so now we have a nice stable wheel and we're gonna attach another long stem to it. And that's gonna be like our front fork. That's gonna hold the whole half a bike together. I'm sorry, not whole bike together, half a bike. Next, I decide to use some floral tape for extra reinforcement. You probably can use any tape that you have on hand. So I decide to cut off the stem at the bottom of the wheel and just continue wrapping around the rim and the whole wheel. Here you can see up close exactly what I did. Now we're gonna take a part from the Happy New Year tiara and we're gonna make a fender out of it. This is a small optional part. It's not a big deal if you cannot find one, or if you really want to make one, you probably can find something around your kitchen that will also work. And I'm gonna use some hot glue to attach the fender to the front fork. We are going to press the planter down a little bit so it lays flat against the wall. And here's why we needed those little foam darts. They're gonna make great handlebar grips for us. We're just gonna attach them with some hot glue. And now time for the paint job. We have to paint everything except the planter. Magic, it's done. And I like the hammered paint because I don't have to distress the bike anymore. I think it looks great. Now we just have to put it together. The bucket comes with a handle. I'm just threading that in. Next, I'm gonna use a lot of hot glue, and you should also use E6000. To attach that fork to the back of the planter, cover it up with a piece of ribbon. You know I like to put a band-aid on everything. I'm also gluing that fender under the bucket as well. Next, I decide to bend down the bicycle fork all the way down inside the bucket, and I try to make a hook out of it to hold my handlebar. But actually, I had to push that handlebar all the way behind, over there behind the bucket, and use a lot of hot glue to attach it there, and also E6000. Put something heavy in there to hold it down and leave it to dry. Next, I use a small stem and a piece of ribbon to create a hanger for our bicycle. I simply bent it down and attached it over there in the back with a lot of hot glue. As you can see, it's a lot of reinforcement over there in the back and on the inside, but at least it all holds up. And here's the look at the finished result. I think we did a pretty amazing job for $1, right? And I love using materials that most of the people toss out. Similar wall decor at Wayfair.com would cost you over $50. So even if you purchase the flower stems and the spray paint, you still wouldn't spend nearly that much. And possibilities are endless. You can put your favorite plant in there, or you can see how I decorated with flowers. You know I use a pool noodle instead of the floral foam to get more bang for my buck. So I cut a piece to size and I glue it inside the planter. And here are the inexpensive flowers I'll be using. First, we have to cut them all to pieces. And as usual, we start off with the greenery. I like the new Dollar Tree fern. I think it's a great quality for $1. And as you can see, I inserted it in a triangle. Here you can see exactly what I did. Next, I am going to insert my big flowers. And these are the beautiful ranunculus that I got a while ago from IKEA. I just love the soft pink color. As you can see, when I insert one on one side, I need to insert another on the other side for the balance. This is a bicycle arrangement. It needs to be balanced out if we want it to hang properly. And here I have a third one I'm going to insert in the center.
enjoying this video so far? If you are, please make sure you hit the like button. It really helps me out. And consider subscribing to my channel because I have many more creative ideas for you in the future. And this is what I love doing the most. Floral arrangements and wreaths and all budget-friendly ideas. If I can do it, you can do it. And I'm here to show you every step of the way and guide you through it. All right, so let's continue. I'll be adding these daisies throughout the arrangement just to fill it in.
And now my all-time favorite Dollar Tree amaranthus. We're gonna add it around for the cascading effect. And now to add a little bit dimension, we're going to insert a few cattails. I have just a few leftovers from Walmart. And now the finishing touch to make sure no foam is showing, we're going to add a little bit of Spanish moss here and there. I didn't glue my stems in because I might change it up for the seasons. But feel free to add your hot glue right now before adding the moss. Let's take a step back, look at the arrangement. Does it look like I took a bicycle ride through the country roads? I think so, right? And I'm debating here whether I'm done or I want to add a bow. If I kept it real, the bow shouldn't go there. But you know what? I have this pretty ribbon here from Joann's and I kind of need a cherry on the top, so I'm just gonna make a very simple bow. I measure about 8 inches tail, then I measure another 8 inches, fold it in half and create a 4-inch loop, then another 4-inch loop at the bottom, measure 8 inches, another 4-inch loop at the top, one more 4-inch loop at the bottom. Pinch it all together in the middle and now make a tiny loop in the middle as well, right there, a little finishing touch. And now I'm gonna cut off the tails about the same length, 8 inches. I want to keep it small so it doesn't overpower my bicycle. I don't want it to cover the beautiful wheel that we made. So here's an old floral stem that I'm gonna tie in the back and create like a pick. Add a drop of hot glue to make sure it doesn't slide off. And I think I want it on the side. Actually, let me remove that cattail that was there and insert it under the flowers. There we go. Here's the look at the finished result. What do you think? Do you like it with the bow better? Or was it better without the bow? I wonder now. Either way, I think it's very beautiful. It adds so much charm to any space. Imagine that on your patio, in your sunroom, entryway. Possibilities are endless here. Like I mentioned, you can insert your favorite plant. You can add sunflowers or lavender. Change it up for different seasons. You cannot go wrong with that. I don't know if you had seen this adorable little sign at a Dollar Tree. It is just too cute. I'm gonna put it right there next to my arrangement. Always make sure that your arrangement looks nice from every angle. And now let me show you how I changed up my window decor. You saw me put up this branch back in February for Valentine's Day. This is what I did for Easter. And now since I have the beautiful cherry blossom blooming in that window, I decided to change it pink. I removed the white magnolias and the string eggs, and I decided to add the pink ones and the cherry blossoms, everything from Dollar Tree. You see how these colors bring the outside in? Isn't that beautiful? The cute birdies are from the Dollar Tree as well. I always get them when I see a new color come up. I also added the little nest right here on the side. And if you're wondering how to make a nest like this, I have a video. I can link it for you below. And I can show you how to make those little eggs. Many of you have been also asking about my windows treatments, so I'm gonna show you them up close. I actually had them custom made in Poland. They're kind of like Roman shades, and they're beautiful because I got to pick my favorite fabric. Like you can see, this has some rhinestones in it, and I picked the colors that I like. And what I love about them is that they easily remove by a Velcro to wash. And you can also roll them up if you like. I really don't have to roll them up because, as you can see, I picked the see-through fabric because I wanted to enjoy that view of the tree. And I also like a lot of light in my kitchen. And here's my view from behind the sink. As you can imagine, I don't mind doing the dishes at this time of the year. Even better when the treatments are up. And by the way, all the flower arrangements that you see, they all have been created and are uploaded on my channel if you're interested to check them out. Oh, let me also show you how I changed up my Happy Easter wreath. I love that pink track, so it was time to take it off because of the eggs and the bunny. And I got this birdhouse sign from Dollar General for just $1. I think it matches perfectly. And then I also added a bird's nest with some eggs and a birdie from the Dollar Tree. Isn't that cute? I removed the wooden eggs, kept the bestie bow and all the florals, and I can enjoy it one more season.
My besties, so this is it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please make sure you like, subscribe to my channel, and see you next time. Take care. Bye bye.